One of the worst parts of an interview is when they ask, "So, do you have any questions for us?" Sheer panic. Hello, everyone. My name is Ellie over here at Fourth. If we haven't met yet, thank you so much for being here. Now that you're here, we would love for you to subscribe below, hit that bell notification so you get all the alerts. Today, we are going to discuss how to prepare and effectively answer the question, "So, what questions do you have for us?" Now, this may seem a little simple, but it is probably the most important aspect to answering this question well. You absolutely need to be listening intently during the entire interview. So many times, people that are being interviewed are so nervous about what they're gonna say, they aren't even listening to the person interviewing them. However, an excellent interviewee is really, really listening, taking notes, jotting down thoughts that they may bring up that are of interest to them. They are just so engaged in the conversation, the back and forth, everything that's being said. When you can really listen and take note of what's being said, and especially if you can take notes while you're listening during the interview, you will naturally come up with questions that make sense in the interview. As an example, you never want to ask a question that is just completely off base of what you're even talking about. One time I was in an interview and I was talking about the specific role that this person was going to be playing, all the day-to-day tasks and kind of the nitty-gritty of what the role entailed. This person I was interviewing, then when asked, "What questions do you have?" they answered with, "What are your company's long and short-term goals?" Whiplash. It was as if they weren't even listening to what I was saying, or that the context of the conversation was more about the actual role. Yes, of course, I could answer that question and give them the goals, but it was just felt like they weren't even paying attention and they just had a list of questions that they were ready to ask as soon as I stopped talking. Now, I do believe that you should prepare with some questions before you ever come to the interview, but the best way to do this is to really niche down and get specific on what you're actually interested in and how that applies to the company. As an example, if you were going in for an interview with a marketing agency and something about marketing that really excited you is this concept of sports marketing, come up with some questions and do your research around what type of sports marketing that this company has done and ask questions around that, because the reality is your interest around sports and your interest around sports marketing specifically is going to come off so authentic versus asking textbook questions that you may or may not really care about the answer. Ask questions that you really care about in regards to working structure. If you are someone who you know that you work better in a big team, make sure to ask about the team size. Make sure to ask about what everyday interactions will look like if you joined their team. You want them to think that you're taking this so seriously and that you're really trying to understand if you would be a good fit, because an interview is a two-way street. You're interviewing them as much as they're interviewing you. And so if you come in with kind of obscure questions or really, really high level questions that don't really pertain to whether you would enjoy working there every day, it's going to come off pretty staged. It's going to come off pretty unaware. And they may even wonder if you genuinely want to work there. Okay, now one other key question I get all the time is, what if I have questions prepared and then they answer them in the interview? I think there's this fear that, oh, I wrote down these questions, but they already answered them. And then when they ask me, "Do you have any questions?" I don't have anything left. This is where the listening comes in to huge play, because just because they've answered that question doesn't mean that you can't bring it up. I'll give a perfect example of this now. Let's pretend during the interview, your interviewer tells you that if you were to be accepted, you would be working on a team of about 7 people. Then when it's time to come and they say, do you have any questions for me? You then look at your piece of paper of questions. One of the questions at the top may be, what is my working team going to look like? You then say, I have a question on here around what my working team would look like. I know that you mentioned I would be working on a team of about 7, but what does that really look like? Is it me with a lot of managers? Is it me and a bunch of my peers? Will I be working with an intern? What is the dynamic of the team? Now, this is doing 2 things. This is showing them that you listened, that you heard that they said that you'd be working with 7 people, because most people they're not even paying attention close enough to catch on to that. So you're showing them that you listened to them, and you are adapting your question. You're showing them that you had that as a question, they've answered it for you, but to take it to another step further, what does that breakdown look like? And now they know you are so serious about figuring out if this would be a good fit for you, if you would fit in well, if that is something that would be setting you up for success. So that's an example of them answering a question that you already had. So instead of looking down at your sheet of paper and saying, nope, I don't have any questions, you answered it all, you're saying, I did come with questions. You've answered these so far, but I want to ask an additional question to kind of take it to that next level. So in a nutshell, the 3 key factors to answering that question is, number 1, listen, listen, listen. Be a good listener, write down notes, and actually pay attention to what they're saying. Number 2 is come with questions niched down into your interests and things that really do get you excited and you genuinely care about the answer to. And number 3, if they've already answered your question, repeat it back to them. Prove to them that you listened and take it to the next level. Ask an additional question, expand on it more, or just say, thanks so much for answering that for me already. I hope this was helpful for you. If you loved it, hit that like button below, and better yet, send it to a career enthusiast just like yourself. Now, if this was not enough for you, if you're just like, Ellie, give me more goods, you are in luck. We are currently building our waitlist for our signature method, Get Hired Bootcamp. In this bootcamp, we dive deep into the job search process, but not just getting the job, but getting that next job, getting that promotion, and excelling in your career. We cover this and so much more, so we would love to have you a part. Hit that link below to get on the waitlist and visit all of our other places that you can access some free 4th content. Well, friends, that's all I've got for you today. Thanks for being here. Go forth and interview on.